attention and openness to learn, to know, to receive the other person, to lead a meaningful conversation. Quality conversations nurture relationship. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Deepening relationships. Uso po ang mga coffee shops. Kaya lang, maselan ngayon. Maraming protocol. Pero earlier, the coffee shops are called the new sanctuary. An article I read before, I just want to share with you why. Because coffee shops, you see people, they are not in a rush. Hindi nagmamadali ang mga tao sa coffee shop. Mabuti pa kung minsan yung mga nagsisimba, parating tumitingin sa relo eh. Pero sa coffee shop, they are there. The time is theirs. And they have small tables, seemingly to connote intimate presence. Yung mga lamesa nila, malilit lamang. Parang only for two or three small groups. And you realize, people stay a long time, sometimes longer than dinners. And you realize, it's not about the coffee. It's about nurturing the relationships. Directly, indirectly, even without them knowing it. It's the quality of the conversations. Wala mang mahingay usually sa coffee shop. Kaya kung minsan na tumatas yung mga kilay ng mga tao sa coffee shop kung may mga tao maingay. Because it's a conversation, a place for conversation. Sabi nga nung title ng article na nabasa ko, coffee shops as the new sanctuaries. Because they bring us together. Coffee shops are places ushering the new age of enlightenment. Sabi nila, in the Middle Ages, great revolutions and great discussions of change did not happen through conferences or seminars or conventions. New ideas, new revolutionary ideas are concocted in coffee shops, sa mga nakukwentuhan, sa mga may oras makinig. No rush. And it creates a lot of conversations. The gospel today is an intimate conversation of Jesus with his disciples. In the gospel from Matthew 16, 13 to 30, 23, it is not about miracles. It's not about healing. Jesus was not even preaching. It's not about forgiving sinners or telling parables. Napaka-unique ng gospel natin ngayon. Jesus is an intimate conversation with his disciples. Who do people say that I am? And then the other question, who do you say that I am? This is a very rare opportunity where Jesus is just with his disciples. Kwentuhan lamang. No synagogue, no Pharisee, no sick people, no crowd. Giving premium to good quality conversations. Sabi nga, bridges are not built overnight. Parang gusto sabihin, if you want to create bridge of friendship, of good relationships, hindi naman madali yan lang. Isang kwentuhan lang, isang bisita, isang panahon na makita tayo. It takes time for this relationship to be deepened. Take note, this is already Matthew 16. Matagal na silang magkasama. This is already half the middle part of the gospel of Matthew. Pero hindi pa talaga siya kilala. Kung mapansin nyo, sabi niya, you are Elijah, or you are John the Baptist, or one of the prophets. Tagal nang kasama si Jesus, hindi pa pala talagang kilala. In fact, even Peter answered him rightly, "You are the Son of God. You are the Messiah." And yet at the latter part of the gospel, he did not understood the mission of Jesus. He would not accept Jesus must die, must suffer, and must be crucified. Kaya sabi naman Jesus, sa later part of the gospel, "Get about me, Satan. You are not speaking from God, but the way people do." Para bang sinasabi, hindi pa tapos dito ang pagpapakilala kay Jesus. I realize, it's not about the coffee, it's about the relationship that is nurtured, deepened every time we have our coffee time. Ito po, ako sa tingin ko, ganyan din po ang pagdarasal. Can our prayer time be like our coffee time? May we enjoy an intimate coffee conversations with the Lord? Si Bishop Ambo, nagtataka ako sa kanya, ang haba ng reflections niya, ang haba ng kanyang writings, daily. Minsan, hindi lang isa, dalawa. Minsan sa Men of Light, we take turns writing the script for Men of Light. Kung sino yung host, ay susulat ng script, and usually we write backup materials. Pero siya, ang tindi niyang sumulat. Very prolific writer. Meron daw sikreto. Early in the morning, while he's having coffee, sinasabay niya ang kanyang pagdarasal. Ang tawag niya, "Coffee with the Lord." And then he read the gospel for the day. Early in the morning, have coffee, and have silence. It's not a boring conversation, therefore, or conversations that be avoided, when one could dominate conversations and could only talk about herself or himself. Ang conversation po kasi, gusto sabihin, free flow of discussion. Hindi lang isa lang yung sasalita. It is not a monologue. What I did, what I think, and what I felt. It's not about me. Kumisan kasi may mga tao, yung conversation, ako lang. Anong naramdaman ko, anong pakiramdam ko, anong nangyari sa akin, anong niisip ko. That is not conversation. It's called the monologue. It does not deepen relationship because you are not ready to listen. You are not open to the other part of the person. Kaya even in Luke chapter 18, nalala yung Pharisee, nagdarasal. Sabi ng Luke chapter 18, "The Pharisee stood in his position and spoke his prayer to himself." Nagdasal siya sa kanyang sarili. Tignan niyo po, "Oh God, I think that I am not like the rest of humanity, greedy, dishonest, adulterous, even now this tax collector. I fast twice a week and I pray tithes on the whole income." Para bang pinaparangalan niya ang kanyang sarili sa harapan ng Diyos. He was praying to himself. He engages not in a dialogue on conversation with God. He was only there with the monologue. Ganyan ba ang ating mga panalangin? Monologue? Kung ano lang ang gusto mo sa Diyos? Kung anong petition mo? Kung anong prayer mo? Or do you also have the time to be quiet and to listen, "Lord, what is your will?" To be sincerely concerned about the other. Isa sa mga pinakamaunang librong binasa ko nung first year college ako, matandang libro na, libro ng uncle ko, na namana ko. It's a very old book. It was written by Dale Carnegie. Ang title, "How to Win Friends and Influence People." It sold more than 15 million during that time. And meron siyang 6 principles on how to win friends and influence people. Meron siyang number 1 principle. Be genuinely interested to the other person. Dapat interesante ka at interesado ka genuinely sa iyong kausap. Hindi pwedeng maging kang interesting kasi ikaw lang ang interesting. You want to listen to them. You want to know them. You want to know what they think and what are their plans, what are their dreams. Sabi nga nung isang expression, the better part of a conversation is in the listening. Tell me about it. How are you? Never seen this before. Kaya nga po ngayon, sa online, ang daming mga available communication gadgets. Ang mga bata, ang daming mga alam sa communication. But there's no guarantee that we are better conversationalists or we are better in conversations if we do not follow our relationship closer to one another, to your children, to yung kasambahay, to your neighbors, to your family, to your friends. Attention and openness to learn, to know, to receive the other person, to lead a meaningful conversation. Quality conversations nurture relationships. Di ba meron tayong expression sa Pilipino, kahit sa Kapampangan? Eda ka kasabi. When you say that, parang hindi ka tana kausap, it means you are cutting your relationship. Hindi na sila nag-uusap. It means their relationship is already cut. The quality of relationship can be only seen in quality conversations. Are you a good conversationalist? It can be answered by the quality of your relationship. Because kung marunong kang makiharap sa ibang tao at makinig, nakikita mo ganun din kaganda ang relasyon mo sa kanila. May I therefore invite you, can your prayer be a conversation? It nourishes a relationship with God and with Jesus, getting to know the Lord more deeply. It leads to a deeper communion with God and our community. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.